Hello everyone, it's Brian Nutter from Summit Racing, and today we're going to talk about dial bore gauges. With a dial bore gauge, it's pretty much a must-have. You measure your cylinder bore with it, your main bores with it. From that, you get your piston and wall clearance and your rod and main bearing clearance from it as well. In this episode of Summit Racing Engine Building 101, we're going to take you through the steps of setting up the dial bore gauge and getting the most accurate measurements from them. We've taken our micrometer, we've set it to 2.0993. That's basically what we had for number one. And we are going to set our dial bore gauge. We're going to zero it off the mic. At this point, we have our Minutoyo dial bore gauge. I'm going to go ahead and float it here inside of our stirrup mic. And what you're going to see is our gauge is moving down, 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 and we're wanting to hit zero right there. That is accurate to 1/10 of 1/1000th of an inch right there. So we know that this dial bore gauge is set to the exact same diameter that the rod journal is on the crankshaft itself. All right, now that we've set our dial bore gauge up, I've taken a connecting rod and piston, in this case number one. Everything has been torqued to that 30 foot-pounds plus 50 degree angle number. That happens to be the number that they use when they actually hone the big end of it. So it is perfectly round right now as it came from the factory. My dial bore gauge, again, set at zero. So whatever zero is basically what the rod journal is. And I'm going to take and insert that into the big end of our connecting rod. Carefully, try not to skin up the bearing. Swinging around, and we're getting close right there at 2/1000ths. And 7/10ths clearance is where that thing dwells. And that, my friends, is perfect for what we want to do here today. Be sure to like and subscribe to get more of our how-to videos, the technical videos, and installation videos. Thank you for watching.